So the third pillar of Atmanirbhar Bharat, inclusive development for aspirational India. Honorable Speaker, sir, under this pillar, I will cover agriculture and allied sectors, farmers' welfare and rural India, migrant workers and labor, and financial inclusion. Agriculture. Our government is committed to the welfare of farmers. The MSP regime has undergone a sea change to assure price that is at least 1.5 times the cost of production across all commodities. The procurement has also continued to increase at a steady pace. This has resulted in increase in payment to farmers substantially. In case of wheat, a total amount paid to farmers in 2013-14, Honorable Speaker, sir, the data that I give now is important for all honorable members to kindly hear. In case of wheat, the total amount paid to farmers in 2013-14 was 33,874 crores. In 2019-20, it was 62,802 crores. And even better, Honorable Speaker, in 2020-2021, this amount paid to farmers was 75,060 crores. Honorable Speaker, again an important fact, the number of wheat growing farmers that were benefited increased in 2020-21 to 43.36 lakhs compared to 35.57 lakhs in 2019-20. That much of an increase within 1 year. For paddy, again, an important data. For paddy, the amount paid in 2013-14 was 63,928 crores. In 2019-20, this increased to 1,41,930 crores. Even better, in 2020-2021, this is further estimated, and I'm saying this is further estimated because the procurement is ongoing, and therefore I can't give you the final figure. This is further estimated to increase to 1,72,752 crores. The number of farmers benefited increased from 1.24 crores in 2019-20 to 1.54 crores in 2020-21. In the same way, Honorable Speaker, sir, in the case of pulses, the amount paid in 2013-14 was 236 crores. In 2019-20, this was increased to 8,285 crores. Now in 2021, it is at 10,530 crores. More than 40 times increase from 2013-14. The receipts to cotton farmers, have seen a stupendous increase from 90 crores in 2013-14 to 25,974 crores. Bound to increase from 90 crores for cotton farmers in 2013-14 to 25,974 crores in 2021. All the details in complete narration is available in Annexure 4 to my speech. Early this year, Honorable Prime Minister had launched the Swamitva scheme. Under this, a record of rights is being given to property owners in villages. Up till now, about 1.80 lakh property owners in 1,241 villages have been provided cards. I propose during 21-22 to extend this to cover all states and union territories. To provide adequate credit to our farmers, I have enhanced the agricultural credit target to 16.5 lakh crores in this year. We will focus on ensuring increased credit flow to animal husbandry, pashupalan, dairy, and to matsyakar, to the fisheries. We are enhancing the allocation to the Rural Infrastructure Development Fund from 30,000 crores to 40,000 crores. The micro irrigation fund with a corpus of 5,000 crores has been created under NABARD. I propose to double it by augmenting it by another 5,000 crores. To boost value addition in agriculture and allied products and the exports, the scope of Operation Green Scheme that is presently applicable to only tomatoes, onions, and potatoes will be enlarged to include 22 perishable crops. Around 1.68 lakh crore farmers, around 1.68 crore farmers are registered, and 1.14 lakh crores of rupees trade value has been carried out through eNAMS, the National Agricultural Market. Keeping in view the transparency and the competitiveness that eNAM has brought into the agricultural market, 1,000 more mandis will be integrated with eNAM. Honorable Speaker, sir, with all this, the Agricultural Infrastructure Fund would be made available to the APMCs for augmenting their infrastructure facilities. Fisheries, I'm proposing substantial investments in the development of modern fishing harbors and fish landing centers. To start with, 5 major fishing harbors, Kochi, Chennai, Vishakhapatnam, Paradip, and Petua Ghat, will be developed as hubs for economic. Fish landing centers along the banks of rivers and waterways. Seaweed farming is an emerging sector with potential to transform the lives of coastal communities. It will provide large-scale employment and additional incomes. To promote seaweed farming and cultivation, I propose a multi-purpose seaweed park to be established in Tamil Nadu. Migrant workers and laborers